Hello everyone, and welcome back to ChemisTea Time. I hope you are having a wonderful day so far. We are going to be continuing on with learning about exceptions to electron configurations and begin to introduce some periodic trends. We have just begun to learn how to write electron configurations for elements on the periodic table. However, it is important to talk about a handful of exceptions that we can encounter when dealing with certain D group elements. It is important to keep in mind that these atoms want to become stable, so that is why in some cases we have these exceptions. As we learned in the previous lesson with filling orbitals, the 4s orbital is filled prior to the 3d orbital because these orbitals are very close in energy. According to Hund's rule, orbitals are more stable as either half-filled, which maximizes spin, or fully filled orbitals. With this in mind, we can apply this to elements in the same group as both chromium and copper. Chromium, if you were to follow the off-bar principle, would be argon 4s2 3d4. However, because the 4s and 3d orbitals are so close in energy, a more stable arrangement would be argon 4s1 3d5. Because this has two half-filled orbitals, instead of a full s orbital and a partially filled d orbital, making this a more stable arrangement. Another case where we see an exception to the rule is with copper, where if you were to follow the off-bar principle, it would be argon 4s2 3d9. However, a more stable arrangement would be to promote an electron to have a fully filled d orbital and a half-filled s orbital, thus making an electron configuration of argon 4s1 3d10. It is important to note that this trend is noted for elements in the same group as chromium and copper. In the next part of this lesson, we will be introduced to trends on the periodic table that affect radius. Before we can talk about these trends, we have to introduce an important concept called effective nuclear charge, which is the net charge that the outermost electrons experience. This refers to the positive charge that an electron feels by the nucleus. However, the valence electrons do not always feel the full effect of the nuclear charge. This is because core electrons shield the outer electrons from the pull of the nucleus. Shielding is present when the principal quantum number, n, is 2 or higher, because below this, atoms do not have core electrons. Core electrons feel a more positive attraction to the nucleus than valence electrons, because valence electrons are on the outermost orbitals and furthest from the nucleus. Due to this, these electrons experience a smaller attraction force. As you move across a period, the number of core electrons stay the same, so the shielding effect that these electrons feel does not change across a period. So the effect of nuclear charge is the dominating factor. As you move across the period, the size of the shell remains roughly the same, but the effect of nuclear charge increases, thus bringing the valence electrons closer to the nucleus. This then has an effect on the atomic radius, which is the distance between the nucleus of an atom and its valence shell. The atomic radius decreases as you move across the periodic table because of effective nuclear charge. As you move down a group, the effective nuclear charge is minimally affected because even though you are increasing the number of core electrons, you are also increasing the nuclear charge, which compensates. However, as you move down the periodic table, your atomic radius increases because you are increasing the number of shells in your atom. It is important to note how atomic radius is affected across the periodic table and how it relates to the effective nuclear charge. Let's review this once again and make note how the atomic radius changes. As you move left to right, the atomic radius decreases because the effective nuclear charge increases. As you move down the group, the atomic radius increases due to the increased number of shells. Well, I hope today's short lesson has been informative. Next time, we will learn how periodic trends tie into ionization energies. Until then, Have a wonderful day.